and civilians in the workforce. We can't compete necessarily with the salary, but we offer a lot of opportunities to do something good for the nation. It's great to hear from Madison Perella about her passion for coding and the passion she's developing for coding. There have been a lot of studies, that talk about the, girls and boys and their differences in interest there. What do you think we can do about that trend, about building more into education and how we can solve that more systematically? But Dan, can you talk a little bit from the education point of view?
At Georgetown, trends in terms of 1985, 37% of computer science majors were women. 2010, it was 14%. And, what is happening to the girls and where are they going? And again, when we look at the studies, we see that there's equal interest at the elementary school level, but where it really drops off is in middle school, and it drops further off in high school. So then you have this funnel effect. If girls in middle school and high school are not imagining themselves in a career in technology, if they're not participating in activities that give them that analytical background, if they're not doing STEM in school, it's very hard for them to re-enter when they get into higher education. So what can we do to actually change the trend early? One of the things that Georgetown is that we're working with the National Group of Girls Who Code to sponsor a summer camp that's free to attract many girls to work together to create a community where they can see themselves working in technology. I see this with my own 10-year-old who's very interested in robotics, and I think she was actually born to code. However, this summer, she's really questioning, I don't know that I want to do the robotics camp, because